Hey guys, welcome back to the next video, and this time Jiushark is back on the channel with the JF500 Ruby, and look how thick that is. Well, and guys, look who's back on the channel. There is Jiushark, and this is one of their brand new coolers. This is the 12cm two towers CPU radiator. So let's get this opened and take a look, shall we? Greatness in simplicity, back to the nature. Nice. Okay, so manual. This will show you how to install it through AMD as well as Intel, because this will support all the latest sockets like AM4, AM5. But they'll tell you how to clip them in. And then obviously there's for AMD, but there tells you how to install them. And that's pretty much it for that. Okay, so the mounting mechanisms for Intel AMD. So yeah, that's it for there now. Right, this is a little certificate. So this was production date for there. Oop, Spectre, lovely. Right, oh wow. Okay. Now what I will say is Jiushark haven't been on the channel for about 2 years, but I've been very happy with their products. They do very nice quality products, and this one isn't. Ooh, look at that. This one isn't any different. Now, this is a massive air cooler. Look at the size in those fin stacks. That is absolutely massive. Look at it. Then you've got these 120 ultra slim fans. You've got the base plate by here, which is, yeah, it's just one of those. But this type of air cooler, I think it's going to do well. But let's have a look at what specifications there are. Okay, so this is the white version, but it does come in black and it does come in non-RGB. But because this is WELSHYTECH, I love my RGB, so it had to be RGB. In terms of the overall specs, now of course these are 120s, but these are really slim fans. They're only 15mm fans. The hydraulic bearings, the does have 6 heat pipes. The overall fan speeds, it's 800, but between 800 and 1800 RPM. The fan airflow is 23.46 and 64.51 CFM. That's not bad considering these are very thin fans. The air pressure is 0.29, so that's not bad either. The fan noise, they're rated from 18.8 decibels, 29.1 decibels, and the life expectancy is 200,000 hours at temp of 25 Celsius. Now they're 4-pin and they are 3-pin ARGB. Now the TDP for this is 255 watts. To be honest, with how big this is, that this heat stack by here, I might actually believe that. But what I'm going to say is that this is very big. And we're gonna get this on the test bench. And as for like the overall compatibility, it does support LGA 15 series to 1851. That'll be the new Ultra series, and then it does support AM4 and AM5. So let's get this on the test bench and test it out, shall we? Okay, so this is the Jiushark JF500 Ruby. I'm going to put my mic up towards the fan at 50% fan speed and pull away. At 50%, it's barely audible. Same thing, but 100% fan speed. Okay, it's definitely up there when it comes to being loud at 100%. Okay then, so as for the testing methods, as you know, if you were a regular on WELSHYTECH, well, you know what benchmarks I use Cinebench R23, because very, very hard instruction set on any CPU, so it does stress it quite a bit. Then, of course, I use Blender Pavilion and Blender Classroom because both of them do hit it differently because of the overall rendering. So, yeah, and then 3D Mark CPTest because it does an overall benchmark, but it tests out the CPU with single core and multi-core as well. So, as for the room temperature, the room was a little bit higher than normal. It was at 11 Celsius, and then the room did go up to 14 Celsius once both of my testing methods were done. So, as for the CPU power, the highest on 50% fan speed, it went up to 186 watts, but it did go down to 165. CPU clocks were 4.9 and did go down to 4.3, but well above base clock. So here we go. This is 50% fan speed, and this is Cinebench R23. The idles were 26 with a max of 81. Blender Pavilion idles 26 with a max of 79. Blender Classroom idles 26 with a max of 78. And 3D Mark CPTest idles 26 with a max of 73 Celsius. Okay, so for 100% fan speed, now the CPU power did go to 186 watts again, and it did go down to 165 watts. Now, the CPU clocks this time, we did lose 100 megahertz when it came to the CPU clocks. It went from, it was 4.9 a high, but did go down to 4.2, so that's 100 megahertz difference between 50 and 100% fan speed, but it's well above base clock, so I'm going to really worry about that. So, as for the Cinebench R23 run, now the idles were a little bit higher. It's because of me doing the test straight after them. So once 50% done, I do straight away to 100%. So the idles are 29 with a max of 80. Blender Pavilion idles 29 with a max of 78. Blender Classroom idles 29 with a max of 77. And 3D Mark CPTest idles 29 with a max of 71. So what I'm gonna do for you now is put another graph up that shows you this versus, like, let's say the PLS Assassin. There's loads of them. There's also the Be Quiet Dark Rock Pro 5, because this is a dual tower. It might have thinner fans, but still, it's still dual tower air cooler. So I'm going to put a graph here showing you all the other ones I've actually reviewed, or some of them at least, that shows you the overall thermal differences between all of them. So then, you saw the rest of the video. So what do I actually think? Now, what I'm going to tell you is that Jiushark hasn't been on the channel since 2023. Not any reason because of them or me personally, it's just they've been waiting to release new products, and obviously it takes time when you're revamping new products, which I understand that completely. Besides, you know, I've been very busy since 2023. Now, what I'm going to say that I'm not a big fan of is all of this, is that I don't like all these cables, because if you saw through the if you were watching the noise test, you could see this in the background, and I tried my best to get it to look at least decent, and I couldn't. So, Jiushark, you need to try and sort this out. Maybe make the cables a little bit longer, or make them shorter, or try a different standard. There's loads of different standards for ARGB, I understand, for cable management's sake, but that is an absolute pain, because trying to get this look tidy is an absolute pain. Now, as for the cooler itself, I like that it's a big cooler. This is big. Look how thick it is. That, but there, is the backside, and this is the front side. Now, this does, as you probably saw through the overall B-roll as well, this is fine when it comes to RAM clearance, because this part's a lot thinner than the back, so they put also very slim 120s on you. That's fine for clearance. Now, as for the overall design, I like the overall size. It's big and bulky. I wouldn't say I'm a fan of the just scaved copper piping at the bottom. I'm not a big fan of that. I'd rather have a nice cold plate on the bottom, but that's just me. The mounting, very simple, very easy to use, to be honest. That's the experience I've had with Jiushark. As for the overall performance, I think it performed well, especially with the 5900X that has brought down 240mm AIOs before. So, as for performance, it performed well. The performed very well within margin of error personally within a dual tower anyway, performed within what I thought it would perform as. And of course the RGB, they haven't let me down there. They know how much I love my RGB. They do have the RGB effect up here, which I do show in the B-roll. It does look rather striking when it's lit up. But obviously, like I said, there's one thing I don't like, it's the amount of cables, but here it does make it look awfully untidy, and it's quite difficult to actually make it look any nicer. And then, of course, who is Jiushark? Well, they are a company who's based out in China. I have worked with them previously, and quite honestly, I'll tell you that the products are usually good. The other ones I've reviewed, they're very, very good, as well as the downdraft cooler, the JF13K Diamond. That was a very fun CPU cooler to review. I had a very good performing video of that, and I thought it was a fantastic for the value aspect as well. Now pricing, I'll put it by here, because obviously these don't sell in the UK, so pricing's quite hard to find. But if you want to find out anything about Jiushark, I will leave the link for their website down below, and obviously their products, they are good. Like I said, what I don't like, of course, is the cables. I would prefer them to have a base plate, but I understand that does add cost, of course. And try and get rid of all those cables, please, Jiushark. Now, other than that, I do like it. It comes in two different colours, black and white. It does come with non-RGB as well. So that's, if you don't like the RGB, you can easily don't have it. But I think the RGB effect is very subtle. The fans are quite nice, but overall, that's your preference when it comes to lighting and so forth. So other than that, I think it's a good air cooler, and other than that, it gets my stamp of approval. And it's nice to have Jiushark back on the channel, because it's been 2 years since. So yeah, now I've got another air cooler from them to review. This one is even bigger. This one is a massive dual tower. This is probably around the same size as the Peerless Assassin. So make sure you subscribe for that. And as always, I hope you guys have a fantastic weekend ahead of you. This is Richard from WELSHYTECH. Goodbye.